Hi, it's Dan here. I just wanted to show you real quick how to attach painters to your canoe. Painters are the lines on the front and the back of your canoe that you can use to, when you're beaching your boat or for whatever purpose you want to control your boat, you have painters that are on there, which are what these lines are called. And what we're going to do is we're going to attach the painters to the boat, and I'm going to show you a neat way to keep them nice and secure and out of your way until you need them. Put them on the front and the back of the canoe. We're going to use for rope. Right now this is rope. Once it's attached to the boat, it'll be called a line. And in this particular case, a painter. Now, if you look at the rope that I chose here, this is just something that I got at Lowe's. It's an all-purpose poly rope. It floats. That's one thing that you want to make sure that it does, that it's a floating rope. And you'll see that this particular rope is braided around a core. If you get a floating rope that's just a nylon twist rope, you're going to have a rope that's almost impossible to manage. It goes every which way. This stuff works really well. It handles like a piece of rope instead of like that twisted twiney kind of stuff. So that's what we're going to use to make our painters. All right, so for a canoe, a good length to use is about half the distance to the center of your boat. About half the distance of your boat. So if you go to the center of your boat with your cord to about the front, that's about long enough for a painter. That'll give you something that is long enough to handle the boat with. Not necessarily used for lining the boat, which is something that we'll talk about later. Now you can see on this canoe, when it was purchased, it was pre-drilled with this hole that goes through here. Now had I done this, I would have put this grab loop down a little bit lower, probably 3 inches lower. The reason for that is I like to attach my painter to my grab loop. Now if I'm on the shore, say in a river with the current blowing by and I'm trying to pull my boat to the shore, as this is high up, my boat's loaded, it's going to have a tendency to want to tip my boat. Whereas if you put it a little bit lower, it won't tip your boat quite as much. So I would have done that, but this is what we have, so that's what we're going to work with. So we're going to attach our painter here. But what I'd like to show you is how we're going to secure these painters to the deck, and I'll have that ready in just a second. Okay, what we're going to use to secure this line to the deck of this boat, just one of these little bungees. Now, you can get this stuff in bulk rolls, but I just happen to see these at Lowe's, just a little package of four that you can buy with the hooks on them. We're not going to use those hooks, but we're going to use that bungee. And what we're going to do is we're going to bore two holes in the deck right here. Now, one thing that you always want to do is reach under and see what's under here. In this case, this is a Royal X boat. This boat will float full of water without any flotation in it. The material itself floats. So there's no flotation chamber in the front of this boat. There's nothing in the way. There's a little bit of underdeck right here, but it's not going to bother me. Now what I want to do is eventually what's going to happen is I want to be able to just take my painter and coil it up and have it secured down here to the deck. So probably loops probably about that big. I'm going to make sure that it's going to stay on the deck. So I'm going to pick a spot on this deck about right here. And I'm going to go across the deck. I'm going to reach under here and feel, make sure there's nothing in my way to bore my holes. And then I can just take this little hole here. I'm going to use that as a measuring point. I'm not going to stretch this. And I'm going to figure where that hole is going to be right there. I really don't need that yet. And I'm just going to eyeball how far in I need to be. Put my hand under here. Figure it out. And then I'm just simply going to bore a hole. You can use your little cordless drill or your power drill. This just happens to be what I have at the moment. Just a brace and a bit. All right, so now I've bored a hole. Now I'll take my little measuring cord here, and I'll just bring it across so that I get straight across the deck. And I'm going to bore a hole directly across from that first one. It's fun, the old bracing bit instead of the power drill, huh? All right, now I've got my holes drilled. And I'm going to cut one end of this bungee cord. So cut it off before things get out of control. I'm just going to take my lighter, just like you do with any cord. Sorry about the wind today. No control over that. And I'll just remove those two hooks, and that little crimp I'm just going to leave on there. We'll go underneath and feed my cord back up. There we go. Now, what I want to do is put it back down the other hole and tie a knot. So down the hole I'm going to go. I'm going to bring that across so that it's not tight on there, but, you know, kind of firmly up against there. I'm going to pinch it. Now I know where I'm going to tie my knot. I'm just going to tie a knot in that cord. That'll keep it from coming up the hole. Hand knot. Now I have my bungee on. And again, I'm just gonna get a fresh cut on here. I'm gonna take my lighter and get that inside the light fire. There it goes. Don't do that with your bare fingers, because it hurts. Alright, now I'll keep my rope from running out, and I'm just going to secure it to the grab loop here. Is I'll just coil my rope, which is no longer a rope, now it's a line, again called a painter. I'll coil it up, and there you go. Now your painter is secured to the front of your boat. When you need it, you can even take and stick the end like this, or something like that. Just let it sit there. Now when you need your painter, just grab it, and out she comes. Simple way to attach and secure your painters. And when you put this back in, you want to make sure that your grab loop, which really should be a little longer on this boat, we're going to change that. Make sure that your grab loop is still hanging down. And that grab loop comes in real handy when you fall out of your boat and you want to grab your boat. Rather than trying to reach up or in your boat or anything, you have a grab loop that you can hold on to right there. So, there you have it. All right, now what we're going to do is basically we're going to do the same thing, only we're going to put these cords across our thwarts here. And on this particular canoe, it just has one thwart, which is the center carrying yoke. Often you're going to find a canoe also has a rear thwart, especially on a longer boat. This is a 16-foot boat. You get a longer boat than this, you'll always have a rear thwart. Some 16s will have a rear thwart. When you're paddling in the rear, that rear thwart right in front of you becomes very useful when you have this cord strapped across there. You can slide your map in, anything that you want quick access to, and it will also hold your spare paddle down for you. So again, it's the same thing. We're just going to bore a hole with our power drill. That's all the power that the room has. We'll just move over here and we'll put another one in. And we'll do the same thing for these pre-made little bungees. Get a big knife out of here. Set the other piece off there. Touch it off with the lighter. It up through the thwart. Now, would it also be a good idea is if you have some spar varnish or some urethane or whatever, is go ahead and fill the hole with it so that you keep it from rotting out in the middle of the hole. Don't happen to have that with us. We'll do the same thing that we did on the decks. Put my phone under there if it was waterproof or whatever you want to put there. Very handy. And your paddle. Could also be put in there. Now you've secured your spare paddle. Anything else you can use. So it's a very handy little attachment to put on your boat.